come to thee. I come before thee today to bring another video. Not of my own mind, but of the eternal Shekinah. Amen. Oh man, and I pray that she bless my crystalline eye, heart, and throat chakra, but all my chakras, that I may speak not of my own mind, but of the eternal Shekinah. And I just say one of my beloved precepts, which is Psalms 51 and 11. And it goes a little bit like this. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me thy joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with all thy free spirit. Look at the glory, only through the Shekinah that is from the Father shall we get overstanding, which is given to us freely. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, you know what I'm saying? We're gonna talk about some of our beloved ministries that we provide for the chosen children. So if you want to get in contact with us, just go to the Upper Eons on Facebook. That's all capital letters. You know what I'm saying? Also, we got a website. Emails to contact us in the description box at the bottom of the video. The emails is dothemann@aol.com. And my email, they're in the description box. Also, we got a book buying ministry. If you need a Nag Hammadi, contact us in the description box on those emails. You know what I'm saying? We got a food ministry named after my brothers, Rodolph Mothers, called the Shiner Johnson Food Ministry. We also got a video ministry that's also in the description box below the video for my brother Chase and my brother Benaiah. And we also got a blog talk on Sunday, you know what I'm saying, at 11 a.m. But we've been having difficulties with the traffic and holidays, so that's why we haven't been having. But we also got a PAL talk, which is called the Sons of the L, capital letters, number 2. Sons of the L, capital letters, number 2. And that's at 12 a.m. on Sunday. You know what I'm saying? And we also be having problems with that, technical difficulties. These archives attacking us. You know what I'm saying? But that's okay. You know what I'm saying? Because we're going to keep on moving and doing the work and the will of the Father and the Mother. You know what I'm saying? So that is our information. Now, so what we're going to talk about today is, you know what I'm saying, we're going to talk about, we got eating my hands, you know, because they done whitewashed everything, you know what I'm saying. But that is, my brother Big Judah talked about the divine Adam in the symbolism and pictures. And I thought that was profound. I mean, I already had knew that, and I've been studied that, but the fact that he brought it out and it just refreshed my mind of some blessed things that he was speaking of. You know what I'm saying? So that's why I got the picture of the two hands, which supposed to be God touching divine Adam or Adam in the physical body. You know what I'm saying? So that's what we're going to talk about today. So let's move on into the video. All right. Now, see, we gonna, like I was saying, my brother Big Judah, he did a video last week and he was talking about symbolism in pictures. And he is exactly right. Symbolism is all throughout the scriptures. You know what I'm saying? That is the esoteric overstanding that we must overstand to overstand the true meanings of what the great mysteries are. You know what I'm saying? We cannot read the Bible literally. You know what I'm saying? because that Bible has geometry, astronomy, chemistry, mathematics, that's geometry. It has mathematics, geometry, chemistry, astronomy, astrology, and those just some of the things in there. You know what I'm saying? So all those sciences, what we call sciences, but what the ancients call alchemy, is a combination of all those aspects that is in that book to get understanding of what that book is saying. That book is, you know how they said, that's why I said it was profound what Big Judas said. So that's why I'm doing this video, because it's like the spirit spoke to me. You know what I'm saying? It just do that sometimes. You know what I'm saying? When we hear things and it just bring back information that we have. But the Bible is talking about divine man, period. But it's also talking about the true children of God, the 12 tribes. But all of that is in symbology and allegory. You know what I'm saying? Mythology. You know what I'm saying? Pre-dynastic and dynastic. You know what I'm saying? All of that is in that book. You know what I'm saying? It's meant to be like that. Because, like Big Judah brought it before in the Apocrypha, when it said, give the first books you wrote to the worthy and unworthy. That's the Bible. Give those books to the worthy and unworthy. But these 70 books, keep hidden for the wise alone. You understand what I'm saying? So, that's what we're talking about today. What Big Judah did that video on, when he did, it was a divine man or God touching Adam on the earth. Now, what I got a picture up here on the screen is, these are the 12 nerves in your brain. Count them. Start from the left side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then on the right hand side, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 nerves in your brain. You know what I'm saying? I wanted to show you that. Now, I ain't going to try to say all them damn names. You know what I'm saying? Cutting them all up. Look it up for yourself. You know what I'm saying? Hey, let me tell you something. If you got anybody doing videos and they not telling you to look up this stuff for yourself, you know what I'm saying? You need to turn that damn channel. You know what I'm saying? Don't take my word. Look these things up for yourself, that you may have understanding what these things are saying. You know what I'm saying? So, and I know my brother Big Judah tell y'all that. Look it up for yourself. Don't take his word. Exactly. So, 12 nerves in the brain. And to keep it real is more than that, but I ain't gonna get into it. We're gonna stay with the basics. You know what I'm saying? Those 12 nerves represents the 12 disciples. Look at that! Look at that. Those 12 nerves represents the 12 disciples. You know what I'm saying? That is, how can I say this? Well, that is a symbology. I'm going to put it like that, because what I'm going to say was deep esoteric. I'm not trying to go that deep. Today ain't about that. Those 12 nerves is symbology, like Big Judah was saying. It's symbolism. You know what I'm saying? Esoteric, hidden stuff. You know what I'm saying? That's why I tell you the Bible is about divine man. You know what I'm saying? And the 12 tribes of Israel. The whole book is about us. You know what I'm saying? So, with that being said, let's move on into the video. I just wanted to show you that those 12 nerves are in your brain. And it's more than that, but we're going to stay with the 12. You know what I'm saying? Remember that. 12 nerves in your brain. You know what I'm saying? Which represents the 12 disciples. Look at that! Let's move on. All right. Now, like I was saying, Big Judah did a video last week, I think it's 2 or 3 videos back, and this is the picture that he had. Now, on the left-hand side, you got Adam in the physical body. And on the right-hand side, that's a picture of a brain. You see that, the shape around the men. And then the bottom, you see the back of the medulla oblongata. You see the stem that go down the spine. You know what I'm saying? That's a brain. That's supposed to be God or Christ. And if you look inside of that brain, it's 12 men in there with him. That represents Christ in the 12 disciples. That's why I show you those 12 ulnar nerves in your brain. Those 12 disciples represents. That's why I told you the 12 or the 13 is really 13 zodiac signs, and it's really 13 nerves in your brain. That's why that Christ in those 12 men represents 13 cranial nerves in your brain. But they only tell you about the 12. You know what I'm saying? So those 12 aspects mean the 12 disciples and Christ, which give you 13. That's supposed to be divine mind touching Adam in the world. But that connection, like I said, was broken. You know what I'm saying? That's why Adam said, I can't see God no more. Because he was connected to the all mind when he came to the physical body. That connection was broke. You know what I'm saying? So those, that's either is God or Christ with the 12 disciples. That's why I show you the 12 nerves. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to read something that Isaiah said. You know what I'm saying? Now, I ain't going to get into Isaiah, but Isaiah is divine man too. And I'm going to say this. Isaiah is a reincarnation of a divine deity. And I ain't going to get into that today, but I'm going to let you know. Okay, if you look at the history of Isaiah, the same thing that Isaiah did, that's the same thing Enoch did. You know what I'm saying? But also the same thing happened to Isaiah, happened to Abraham. The same story happened to Abraham, happened to Isaiah. Isaiah was shown all the heavens, just like Abraham, to let you know Abraham was much more than what you think he was. I ain't gonna get into that. I ain't gonna get into Isaiah, but they both had the same experience. They were shown everything in creation. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just saying to let you know, Isaiah is not who you think he is. He a reincarnate of somebody else, much higher and much greater. You know what I'm saying? That's why if you look at the scriptures, Isaiah, he knew a damn thing. Excuse my language. So what we're going to do is we're going to read a precept out of the Bible about Isaiah. So when you look at Isaiah, do not look at Isaiah as what the Edomites have told you he is. Isaiah is much greater. And he's one of these entities that reincarnated in his body. You know what I'm saying? But that's another video. Okay, now, basically, we're going to be reading out of this book called The Great Transformation. You know what I'm saying? It's called The Great Transformation. Okay, The Great Transformation of Man. Okay, now, it's going to tell you that we are completing the work of Isaiah. He is exactly right. Because Isaiah ain't Isaiah. That's just an incarnation of the divine being who incarnated in that body. You know what I'm saying? Now, I'm going to go read a little bit out of this. It's on page 26. It says, we here have today to recognize the evidence of that splendid creation. Exactly. You already said, listen very carefully. Listen, baby, let me turn this down. It says, we are here today to recognize the evidence of that splendid creation. He is exactly right. When that Bible say the 7 days of creation, look at the glory. Look at the glory. What is that saying? The 7 days of creation. You know what I'm saying? Now let me tell you something. I can go many ways with this. 7 days of creation. But I'm going to stay with the basics. Read this again. It said, we are here today to recognize the evidence of that splendid creation that did not stop with the seventh day of creation. Exactly. Because when you're reading the Bible, he said all 6 days had ended. But he didn't say they stopped on the seventh day or ended. He just said he rested. You know what I'm saying? Now, I ain't gonna get into it, but I'm gonna say this. See, the seventh day, all the other days, he said it ended, and he went to the seventh day. He just said he rested on the seventh day. That's rested from the physical aspect of creation. That's what that means. He rested on the creation of the physical aspect. Those 7 days of creation is talking about your seven chakras or the seven worlds inside your body. Trust me what I'm telling you. I ain't about to get into that because that's another whole video. But the 7 days of creation is talking about your seven chakras. It's talking about your seven chakras, your seven wheels, your seven books, your seven seals, your seven candlesticks, your seven stars, you know what I'm saying? The seven lampstands, the seven churches. That's what the 7 days of creation is talking about. Your seven chakras in your body. You know what I'm saying? It's talking about the creation of divine man. You know what I'm saying? In the spiritual world first. Because if you read Genesis, it's two creation stories right there. It tell you that it created in the spiritual aspect, and then it come down and say it created him in the flesh. In Genesis right there. So that's why when you read the esoteric text, it say the first light was Adam Kadmon. It say the sun was created on the fourth day. So how could that be the sun on the first day when it say the sun was created on the fourth day? You know what I'm saying? The sun and the stars, the sun, the moon, the stars get on the fourth day. So that first light was divine man in his seven chakras in the heavens. In the Bible, those that two creation stories. But let's move on. Okay, it say, we are here today to recognize the evidence of that splendid creation. That did not stop with the seventh day. It say, the Bible tells us that the first 6 days came to an end. Exactly. But it does not tell us that the seventh day came to an end. Exactly. It say, from the standpoint of higher knowledge. Exactly. It's talking about the end of the creation of the physical aspect of man in the physical world. You know what I'm saying? Because, trust me, you was prepared in heaven to come down into the physical body. You was prepared up in the upper eons to come down in the physical body. That's part of the learning, the schools. All the planets are schools. Earth is a school. You know what I'm saying? But let's keep reading. It say, but it does not tell us that the seventh day came to an end. From the standpoint of higher knowledge, we are still in the higher creation if we choose to be shepherds and wayshowers. Shepherds mean you guide and children back to the truth. And wayshowers is people that show people the way to the esoteric mysteries. You know what I'm saying? And it's much deeper than that. When you a wayshower, to be a wayshower, you know the esoteric overstandings of how to come out your body. You know what I'm saying? That's the real overstanding of a wayshower. But we ain't gonna get into that neither. Okay, it said to be a shepherd or a wayshower, to elevate the direction of the planetary growth. See that? That's what a wayshower really is. You know what I'm saying? It say, our work is to fulfill the vision of Isaiah. See that? Our work is to fulfill the vision of Isaiah. I'm telling you, Isaiah is not Isaiah. Isaiah is one of the first divine beings in that pantheon that was created. You know what I'm saying? But let's keep reading. That's another video. It say, our work is to fulfill the vision of Isaiah, who tells us in chapter 62. Let's go to chapter 62 and see what Isaiah said. Let's go there. Okay. Isaiah chapter 62. We're going to start at, we're going to start at chapter 1. It say Isaiah 62. It say, for Zion's sake, that's talking about all of Israel, will I not hold my peace? I mean, he's going to tell the truth. And for Jerusalem's sake, see that? All of Israel, I will not rest until the righteousness thereof go forth as brightness. See that? Isaiah came to teach you too that you divine man. That's why he said, I will not rest until the righteousness thereof, meaning before creation into the physical body, thereof, meaning before you came into the physical body, go forth as brightness. That's what the Bible says, you shall shine like the stars of heaven. You shall shine seven times brighter than the sun. That's why I say the first light that was created was brighter than the sun. Seven times brighter than the sun. That was divine man. When it says seven times brighter than the sun, it's saying the seven chakras in your body. That's why I keep saying seven times brighter than the sun. Because talk about your seven chakras. The 7 days of creation. See that? Thereof go forth as bright. That's what the Bible says. You're going to shine seven times brighter than the sun, or shine at the stars of the firmament. You know what I'm saying? You're going to be divine man, the first light at the beginning of creation that shines seven times brighter than the sun, because there were seven suns in your body. Okay. And it say, and the salvation thereof before, thereof mean before, it say, and the salvation thereof as a lamp that burneth. See, it's talking about the sun, or divine man that was created before everything. And I did a video about that. The first light that came forth was divine man that shines seven times brighter than the sun, which is your seven chakras created in the heavens first. You know what I'm saying? That's what the 7 days of creation is in. That's what that's about in your Bible. You know what I'm saying? That's why the seventh day, it didn't stop, because the seventh day connect back with your Christ over self, your divine man. You know what I'm saying? So that's the importance of what Big Judah was talking about when he was showing you that picture of divine man inside of the brain with the 12 disciples. You know what I'm saying? Verse 2, listen to this. It say, and the Gentiles shall see thy righteousness. See that? All the people on earth gonna see a shine like the stars of heaven. And all kings thy glory. See that? And thou shalt be called by a new name, which thy mouth of the Lord shall. The Most High gonna give us our new name, which is a divine name. That's why in Revelation it say, when you get restored, you gonna get a white stone with a name that nobody else know. That's only the Father know, which is given to you. And that white stone represents masonry. My son, M-Y-S-U-N, my son, a mason. That's what that white stone mean, the cornerstone. But that's another video too. I ain't gonna get into that. Now, in precept 2, Isaiah 62 verse 2, they left out a very important word. Now listen to this. It said, and the Gentiles, wait a minute. It said, and all nations will certainly see your righteousness, O woman. Okay. In verse 2, it said, and the Gentiles shall see the righteousness and all the kings thy glory. Now, when it say thy glory, it really say, O woman. See, they took away the feminine aspect. Verse Isaiah 62, verse 2, it say, and the Gentiles, meaning all the people of the world, shall see the righteousness and all kings thy glory. It really said, O woman. Because didn't the Bible say he equate Israel to a delicate woman? See, they took away the feminine aspect. It said thy glory, but it really said, O woman, meaning O Israel, the female aspect. Jerusalem mean the female aspect too. Okay, now that's all we're going to read out of the Bible, but we're going to read what this book say Isaiah 62. It say verse 2. And all nations will certainly see your righteousness, O woman. See that? It say the female metaphor is used for the image of man. See that? Let me read that again. It say the female metaphor is used for the image of man. See that? That's why I told y'all. I'm gonna do that video about divine woman. Is we gonna be saved through the feminine principle, period. I ain't gonna get into the rest of that. It say the female metaphor is used for the new image of man, for it conveys the birth of the new man. Exactly. The feminine aspect. Even that's telling you, through the woman you shall be saved. It's a metaphor for the man being divine man. It say 3. And you must become a crown of beauty in the hand of your God, and a kingly turban in the palm of your God's hand. See that? Now, it say the turban is seen here as a higher mind. See that? On the right hand side, that's what Big Jude was talking about. The higher mind. Talking about Christ in the 12 disciples. That is your higher mind that touched Adam Cabin in the physical body. But that connection was broken from the silver, not from the silver cord, but that connection was broken, that divine connection. That's why Adam said, I can't see God no more. That connection was broken on purpose. All of this, see, when it say we fell, it was meant for us to fall. Now, I'm going to leave that alone. Okay. It say the turban or the crown is seen here as a higher mind. That's what that picture on the right with the brain in Christ and the 12 disciples, that connection to your higher mind, your Christ over self. It say, in an ancient symbolic language. See that? An ancient symbolic language. That's what Big Judah was saying. The symbology in the pictures and in the words and in the art. It say, an ancient symbolic language resting upon the crown of the 7 chakras. Exactly. The crown or the turban is your divine mind or the 7th chakra. The 7th chakra is the 7 days of creation. That's why it didn't say that the 7th day ended, because the 7th day you just rested. That means your knowledge don't go no higher until you connect back with the all mind. It was meant for the connection to be broken. See that? Okay. It say through which the 7th ray of light comes. See that? That's why I say the 7th day you just rested. That's talking about the physical aspect of man. Because it goes from the 7th on to the spiritual aspect of creation. You know what I'm saying? So that's how important that picture was that Big Judah was talking about is. You know what I'm saying? Man. That's why the Shekinah had me pick up on this. To help piggyback on what that brother already had said. You know what I'm saying? Oh, it was a blessing for him, for the spirit, for her to give him that understanding. You know what I'm saying? That he brought it to y'all. And this right here show y'all that he was not talking crazy. You know what I'm saying? That brother was bringing y'all truth, light, wisdom, and understanding. You know what I'm saying? So let's move on. All right. Now, I'm going to show y'all that the 12 or 13 cranial, I'm going to stay with 12. I'm just stay with 12. Because when you read the book of Sophia, it tell you that Sophia could not go back to the 13th eon. That is the monad. You know what I'm saying? But I'm going to leave that alone. You know what I'm saying? Or it's the monad. You know what I'm saying? So I'm going to leave that alone, though, because that's another whole video. But it's the 13th realm. That's why it's 13 signs of the zodiac. 13 Ornell nerves in your brain. The 13th sign of the zodiac is Ophiuchus, which I told you is Asclepius. You know what I'm saying? But that's another whole video. I'm going to go into Nag Hammadi on page 112. I'm in the Nag Hammadi on page 112. I'm going to show you what the 12 Ornell nerves represents. You know what I'm saying? In your brain. You know what I'm saying? And then what else I read right here on the screen, it's going to tell you what those 12 disciples really represents. Okay. I'm on page 112 in the Nag Hammadi. It say, now from the light, which is the anointed. Wait a minute. It said, now from the light, which is the anointed, and from incorruptibility. See, these 12 nerves, or these 12 aspects, or these 12 principles, is from the incorruptible. That's from the upper eon, or the Abdo, or the Monad. That is the higher pantheon. You know what I'm saying? It say, by the grace, which is the feminine aspect, of the Spirit. See that? By the grace of the Spirit. That's the feminine aspect, the Divine Mother. It say, the four luminaries. The four luminaries is the 12 aspects. Now watch this. The four luminaries that was given to Messiah. That's why inside that brain is really talking about Messiah and the 12 disciples. Messiah was given the four luminaries to create the 12 disciples. You know what I'm saying? That's why Christ said, when he came down, we came down with him. Now I'm going to show you what the 12 aspects are, or the 12 disciples, or the 12 nerves in your brain. Page 112 in the Nag Hammadi. And it's in the book, the secret book of John, in the Nag Hammadi. It say the four luminaries that derive from the divine self-generated, the self-generated is Messiah, gaze out in order to stand before it. It said, the four powers are, these are the four powers that Christ was given from the Divine Mother. Overstanding, grace, perception, and thoughtfulness. Those are the four powers given to Christ that makes up the 12 aspects, or the 12 disciples, or the 12 ordinary nerves in your body. Now you see how everything from the higher realms come down in the physical aspect? That's why I said those seven, the 7 days of creation are about the seven chakras in your body. Now it say, on the right hand side, it said, grace dwelled in the eternal realm of the luminaries. Hormazel, who is the first angel, there are three other eons with the eternal realm. So in the first, those four aspects have names. If I'm saying it right, it's called Hormazel, Oriel, David Thoth, and Elilith, Eleth. Those are the four powers of those angels. In the name of his overstanding, that is Hormazel. Grace is Oriel, if I'm saying the name right. Perception is Davitha, and thoughtfulness is Elilith. You know what I'm saying? Those are the four angels, or the four aspects, or the four powers given to Messiah to create the 12 disciples. Now, Hormazel got grace, truth, and form. Oriel got insight, perception, and memory. Davidoff have overstanding, love, and idea. And Elilith have perfection, peace, and Sophia. Those are the 12 aspects, or the 12 corner nerves in your brain. Those are the 12 aspects that came down with divine man. Christ himself is telling you about your own self. You know what I'm saying? And I can get into something about that, but I'm not. Christ is telling you about your own 12 aspects inside of your brain, inside of the Nag Hammadi. Those four powers gave you the three, each one of those powers got three aspects, which give you 12. You know what I'm saying? Those are the four powers that give you the 12 aspects that's inside of your brain. These are the aspects that came down with you into this world, or what is called, the earth is called a school, which you came down here to master those 12 aspects. You came down here to master those 12 aspects. in the physical body. And the Gentiles have taught you all the way different what those 12 aspects mean. You know what I'm saying? You came out here to master every last one of those aspects in the physical body. Now, let's read what's on the page to show you that. Lack of the glory. Now we're going to go inside of the book of Sophia. We're going inside of the book of Sophia right now. And we're going to read about those 12 disciples or 12 aspects right there on the page. That's why I told you all the chosen children are Christ. Christ is your Christ over self that connects to your I am self. Your I am self is the all mine. That's when you become a creator God. But let's read on the top. It say, Jesus now reveals that. Read it again. Jesus now, or Messiah. Messiah now reveals that he has chosen his disciples from those who were with him at the beginning. See, those 12 aspects was with Christ at the beginning when he was given the four powers, Harmazel, Uriel, David Thoth, and Lilith. If I'm saying those names right, which I know I ain't really, but go on to Nag Hammadi, like I told you, and look them up for yourself. Each one of those four powers has three aspects, which give you 12. You know what I'm saying? Those are the 12 disciples. Now listen what Christ said again. Christ is really you. This talking about you coming down as divine man into the physical body with those 12 aspects or the 12 disciples. You know what I'm saying? It say, Messiah now reveals that he has chosen his disciples from those who were with him at the beginning. See, I just read those who was with him at the beginning. I'm going to read them again. Let me read who was with him at the beginning. You know what I'm saying? Read who was with him at the beginning. At the beginning, it was, bear with me. Wait a minute. At the beginning, it was, bear with me. At the beginning with Christ, it was Christ asked the Divine Mother to give him four powers, which was Harmazel, Uriel, David Thoth, and Lilith. And those four powers initially are called understanding, grace, perception, and thoughtfulness. The 12 disciples is called grace, truth, form, insight, perception, memory, overstanding, love, idea, perfection, peace, and Sophia. Those are the aspects, the 12 disciples, that came down with Christ. Now let me go back to the screen and read it again to give you understanding of what it's saying. Messiah now reveals that he has chosen his disciples from those who were with him at the beginning. See that? That's when Christ asked the Divine Mother, can he create? And she gave him the four powers, and each one of those powers got three aspects, which give you the 12. Those are the 12 disciples. See how deep that picture was Big Judah was talking about? Let's keep reading. It say, before the world was, see that? Those are the seven chakras or the 7 days of creation. Before the world even was. That's why I say in the book of Genesis, if you read it very carefully, you can see the two creation stories right in the book of Genesis. It said, before the world was, and from those who will be with him when the world is no more. When it's talking about Christ, it's really talking about you. You, Christ. These aspects came down with you in the physical body, and when you go back up, these 12 aspects going to be with you in the upper eons too. That's what it's really telling you. It say, when it ascends into the new world is the upper eons where you are from. That's why Christ said, I am from above and ye are from below. That's in John in the Bible. You know what I'm saying? It say, within the splendor of the new heavens, right, where you are originally from. know what I'm saying? It say their 12 power. It said their 12 powers came from the 12 saviors. Right. The 12 saviors is the 12 names I gave you. That comes from the four powers that Messiah had. Those are the 12 saviors. And it means more than that too, but I'm just trying to keep it simple. It say in the treasury of light. Right. Those 12 aspects came from the treasury of light where Christ came from. It say, whose overstanding of the mysteries proceed directly from the divine source to the 12 disciples. See that? From the treasure of light, those divine aspects came from the divine source, the all mind, the father and the mother, the divine source. See what I'm saying? It say, to the 12 disciples. See that? The 12 aspects I just told you. Each one of those sources that Messiah got came from the divine father and mother. You know what I'm saying? It say Messiah explains that his disciples were preconditioned in the higher heavens to take on the embodiment of form. See that? When you was in upper eons, you was prepared to come down in a physical body. That's why when you read in the book of Genesis, when it talk about the first days of creation, and then it said, and then Adam and Eve, he created them. I'm saying that wrong, but anyway, it said he created them. That was talking about, when it said he created him and her, he created them. That was divine man. Then you keep reading and it say he created Adam and Eve. That was the physical aspect. But when he said he created him, he, her, and them, that was divine man. So when you read Genesis, it's talking about two creation stories right there in your face. Let's keep reading. It said, Messiah explains that his disciples were preconditioned in the higher heavens to take on the embodiment of form. See that? Before you came down into the physical body, you was already trained to come into the physical body from the upper eons. That's why I told you, you volunteered to come down here. Let's keep reading. It say, in the process of birth, in the blueprint of creation. Right. The blueprint is in the upper eons. The physical body is the microcosm of the macrocosm. That's why I say, as above, so below. The blueprint below in the lower worlds is a microcosm of the big blueprint in the macrocosm. That's why Enoch told Asclepius that Egypt is the image of heaven on earth. Egypt is a microcosm of the macrocosm in the heavens. As above, so below. See what I'm saying? It say the cosmic memory of mind. See that? That's where you come from. The cosmic memory of mind, or gnosis. You know what I'm saying? It say, or cut off. See that? That's why Adam say, I can't see God no more. Because when he came in the physical body, he was cut off from the all mind. Just like I just was saying. It say, the cosmic memory and mind, gnosis, are cut off. So that as man or woman comes into the lower spheres of influence, the higher attributes are no longer recalled. See that? Those attributes or those 12 aspects that, or the 12 disciples that's in the upper eons that Messiah had and you had, which you are Christ, as your Christ self, they was cut off. If you connect back with your Christ self, then you have connection back with those 12 aspects or the 12 disciples. Those are the ones that teach you each one of those aspects. Each one of those disciples have an aspect that you learn. Let me read them again. Let me read the 12 disciples again. You know what I'm saying? Read the 12 disciples again. The 12 disciples are grace, truth, form, insight, perception, memory, overstanding, love, ideal, perfection, peace, and Sophia. Those are the 12 aspects that you've been cut off from and you only got a teeny bit of it in the lower realms. That's what you was cut off from. The higher Christ over self. Your higher mind. You are Christ. That's why I say at the end is going to be many Christs. You know what I'm saying? Those are the aspects you came out here to learn. But like the book say, it say, the cosmic memory and mind, gnosis, are cut off so that as man and woman come into the lower spheres of influence or the archons, the higher attributes are no longer recalled. See that? It means, that's why I say you got to raise up out of the physical body and connect back with those attributes. You know what I'm saying? They can't come down to you. You know what I'm saying? It say, least the one who dwells on the earth be overloaded with the change in the light energies. See, that's why that higher aspect of your Christ self, it can't come down to you, because the bottom line, it'll kill you. That is the cosmic wave that's coming. That's why it said, those no longer recall. It said, least the one who dwells on earth be overloaded with the change in the light energies. So if those 12 aspects came down on you at once, it'll make you go crazy or to kill you. You know what I'm saying? But that's the wave, the Christ over stuff that's going to come down. You know what I'm saying? Right now, we're supposed to be trained to go up to it, but we've been thwarted. So now it's going to have to come down to us to raise us back up. You know what I'm saying? See how Christ and the 12 disciples all relate back to us? That picture Big Judah was talking about, see how important that picture was? Let's keep reading. It said, the meaning is that each one of us has a divine double. Right. Your divine double is your Christ over self. You know what I'm saying? That's the other half of you. You know what I'm saying? I can get into something, but I am. I'm just going to keep reading. It say, a divine counterpart, which is used not only for the programming of the flesh. See that? That programs, that's how the Holy Spirit speaks through you, through your Christ over self. It say, a divine counterpart, or your Christ over self, which is used not only to program the flesh, but also for its quickening. See that? The Christ over self is going to come down and quicken you or change you into Christ. See what I'm saying? See how important that picture was Big Judah was showing? You know what I'm saying? It say, into the higher dimensions of evolution. See that? You're going to be Christ again. You was Christ before you came down into the physical body. You know what I'm saying? It say, behold, the greater family, which is the great white brotherhood, behold the reason that you have come as separate parts and vehicle forms that now must be merged together. Exactly. The age of Aquarius, your Christ over self gonna come down onto your physical body, and you're gonna become divine man, or Adam Cadman, Christ. You know what I'm saying? That's why the Bible said only through Christ can you see the Father or the All Mind, through your Christ over self. Let's go to the last part. It says, Jesus or Messiah explains to the disciples after his resurrection that they also have a light body too. See that? See, when Christ resurrected after the 3 days of darkness, after the 3 days into the grave, well, that mean that too, but after the 3 days, he was in the grave, and he came back in his light body, and he told the disciples, don't touch him. He telling you, you got a light body too. So that also shows you that you are Christ also. It say, Messiah explains to his disciples after his resurrection that they also have a light body also. You know what I'm saying? It say, known as the body of Zohar. The body of Zohar is all the colors of the rainbow. Your light body. You know what I'm saying? And that regardless of the vicissitudes of the earth planes and the lower worlds, so basically what it's saying, regardless of the principalities, that Paul was talking about. Spirits, is Paul said, you fight not against blood and flesh, but spirits and principalities from above. That's what Christ just saying. It say, and that regardless of the vicissitudes of the earth planes and the lower worlds, those are the spirits and principalities that you fight against. Ascension will be granted to all who can elevate. See that? Let me read that again. Ascension will be granted to all who can elevate beyond this space and time. See that? So what he's saying is, everybody who got the light spark, all of y'all gonna evolve or elevate to the higher eons. That's just like the video I did last week, when it said some gonna ascend when that wave come. The wave is your Christ over self coming down into the physical world. That's what the keys of Enoch are talking about when it said all these light ships gonna come down to the earth. Guess what those light ships are? Merkabas. That's why I say gonna be thousands of them. These Merkabas is gonna come down to the earth and come on to the physical body, just like Christ. Remember, the Holy Spirit came down. The Holy Spirit is the dove. The dove represents the Merkabah. The Merkabah is all those light ships that they said, that they talk about in the keys of Enoch, the book of knowledge. It say thousands of them gonna come. Those are spiritual Merkabahs. That's when it say the descent of the soul, and you left your Merkabah or your garment up into heaven, your Christ over self. That's going to come back down and come on to all the chosen children, because they know who you are. They're going to come back down on you, and you're going to become divine man or Adam Cabin once again. All those light vehicles, those are Merkabas. And they're going to come down and find the other half, and they're going to become divine man. That's why I told you some going to go crazy. Some, the first one's going to ascend back to the divine man. Some going to lose their damn mind, and others going to kill themselves. Because the divine Merkabah, that wave, ain't come for them. You know what I'm saying? See how all this makes sense now? That picture Big Judah showed, look how much go with that. Let's keep reading. It say, and that regardless of the vicissitudes of the earth planes, see, the earth planes are the seven days of creation, or your seven chakras. They whirl. And the lower worlds, see that? The lower worlds. Ascension will be granted to all who can evolve beyond this space and time. See that? All the chosen children got a divine spark in them. The Merkabah going to come down on them. That's why when they show on TV that white light or the white dove coming down on Christ, that Merkabah ship. That's what the keys of Enoch keep talking about, those white ships that's coming. It's a symbolized in the resurrection of the cross, which typifies the body. That's why I was telling y'all, when you stand up and put your feet together and hold your arms out, that's the cross Christ talking about. That's the cross Christ died on, not no stick or no tree. The tree represents the tree in your body, your seven chakras, in the physical body. Christ died on the physical seven chakras. The cross, which is your physical body, or it say Christ conquered death. Death or the cross is your physical body. That's what Christ conquered. It said right here. It say, symbolized, it say, and that regardless of the vicissitudes of the earth plane and the lower worlds, ascension will be granted to all who can evolve beyond this space and time. It means all who are chosen. Symbolized in the resurrection of the cross, which testifies the body within the space and time. See that? The cross is your physical body. Conquering death. Death is the physical body. Christ is your Christ over self. You are Christ. That is the point of the picture that Big Judah showed y'all in his video. You know what I'm saying? Listen to this. It say, for I have told you many times. This ain't on the screen. For, For I have told you many times that the powers that is written within you, I have brought from the 12 saviors who are in the treasure of light. Those are the 12 aspects that Christ talking about in the Naga body. They come from the treasure of light, and they are in your body, in your Christ self, which are the spiritual 7 chakras, and in your physical body, which are the physical 7 chakras. See how all that go together? Let me keep reading and say, therefore, I have said to you from the beginning that in truth, you are not of this world, nor am I of it. See, we come from the upper eons, the third eternal eon. You know what I'm saying? It say, for all beings who are in the world have received their souls or spirits from the powers of the archons of the eons. See that? See, he said the chosen ones got their soul and spirits from the upper eons, but the Gentiles got their spirits from the archons. We'll read that again. For all beings who are in the world have received their spirits from the powers of the archons of the eons. See, all the Gentiles got their spirits from the archons, the lower worlds. We come from the upper eons, where Christ come from. That's why Christ said, I'm not from this world. That's why he said, therefore, I have said to you from the beginning that in truth, you are not of this world, nor am I of it. See that? That's why Christ said in John, I am from above, ye are from below. He was telling the Gentiles that, the Pharisees. See what I'm saying? For all beings who are in the world have received their spirits from the powers of the archons of the lower eons. But the powers which is in you is from me, and your soul belongs to the heights. The powers of the 12 saviors of the treasury of light I have brought, taking them from the portion of the power which I received from the beginning. The power that he received from the beginning is the power that the divine mother gave him from the beginning to create. And that's how all the chosen children was created. We are from the upper eons. We are not from below. You know what I'm saying? So that's the importance of what Big Judah was showing y'all in the video that he did when he showed you that divine picture of divine man, you know what I'm saying, that was touching Adam Kapman in the physical body. Now you see why the 7 days of creation, what that's really talking about. It's talking about you being created in the upper eons and coming down into the physical body. As above, so below. You got 7 chakras of the physical body, or 7 wheels, or 7 seals, or the 7 books. You know what I'm saying? That's why the Bible said, That's why the Bible said the books will be open at the end in Revelations. Talking about your 7 chakras, or your 7 worlds, or your 7 seals, or your 7 wheels. They're going to be open and tell everything that you've done in this physical reality. And you got 7 books or wheels or seals in the upper eons too. That's why the 7 days of creation tell you that in the book of creation, in Genesis, it's telling you about the 7 days of creation, talking about up in the upper eons when you was created at. You know what I'm saying? So that's what all this stuff is talking about. So that's why when Big Judah did that video, I'm telling you, showing you how important that was. So with that being said, I thank y'all for coming out. You know what I'm saying? I thank y'all for listening to the video. And with that being said, if you like this information, come join us in the Upper Eons, all capital letters, on Facebook. You know what I'm saying? Other than that, I say peace and love to the gods known and unknown. Peace be unto you, brothers and sisters. Shalom. He loves us, whether or not.